Hello students, in our today's class we are going to study about equal fractions. Shilpa, Hussein and Naveen wished to have Dilpasand, so they went to a bakery. Shilpa, let us have a Dilpasand. Hussein, one each, wow. Naveen, for me, one Dilpasand. Now, Shilpa, out of two equal parts, she ate one part. Okay, out of two equal parts, she ate one part. Okay, that means she ate 1/2, right? 1/2. Now, next one. Hussein, out of four equal parts, he ate two parts. Okay, he ate two parts. That means he ate 2/4, right? Next one is Naveen. Naveen, out of eight equal parts, he ate four parts. So, we can say that he ate 4/8. Shilpa took 1/2, Hussein took 2/4, and Naveen took 4/8. Observe the shades of each of them. Okay, here that is 1/2, 2/4, and 4/8. What do 1/2, 2/4, 4/8 represent with respect to a whole Dilpasand or the whole fraction? These three are half of the whole, isn't it? Here you see, whole is divided into two equal parts. One is taken by Shilpa. Here, out of four, he will eat two parts, right? You see here, half is remaining. Here also. Here there are eight parts, he will eat 1, 2, 3, 4. That means each represent half of the whole, right? So, fractions showing same quantity are called as equal fractions. So, we say that 1/2, 2/4 and 4/8, they are equal fractions. They are equal fractions. What are equal fractions? Fractions showing the same quantity are called as equal fractions. Now let us study about equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions. See the question here. Write three equivalent fractions of 2/3. Now, how to find out the equivalent fractions of 2/3? First, what you have to do is you have to write 2/3 as it is. Okay, 2/3 as it is. Then what you have to do is you have to multiply it by 2. By nominator and denominator both, you have to multiply by 2 and write the answer. So 2 2's are 4, 3 2's are 6. So 4/6 is the one of the equivalent fractions of 2/3. Now what you got the answer? It is 4/6. Okay, this is one of the equivalent fraction. Now again write 2/3 and multiply the numerator and the denominator by 3. Here you multiply it by 2. Here you multiply it by 3. 2 3's are 6. 3 3's are 9. So answer is 6/9. Again you write 2/3 as it is. Multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. 2 4's are 8. 3 4's are 12. Therefore we can write it as equivalent fractions of 2 by 3 r, write this 4 by 6, 6 by 9, 8 by 12. See the second question. Here you have to find the equivalent fractions of 4 by 5. First, what you have to do, multiply by 2. 4 2 is 8, 5 2 is 10. So, 8 by 10, again 4 by 5, multiplied by 3. 4 3 is 12, 5 3 is 15. So, it is 12 by 15. Again, you write 4 by 5, multiply by 4. So, 4 4 is 16, 5 4 is 20. Therefore, equivalent fractions of 4 by 5 are 8 by 10, 12 by 15, 16 by 20. Now we have to find the equivalent fractions of 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 multiplied by 2, right? You write the answer. Then 1 by 4 multiplied by 3. Then 1 by 4 multiplied by 4. So you see here, 1 2 is 2, 4 2 is 8, right? 1 3 is 3, 4 3 is 12. 1 4 is 4, 4 4 is 16. Therefore, you write equivalent fractions of 1 by 4 are 2 by 8, 3 by 12, 4 by 16. Similarly, you have to find the equivalent fractions of the given fraction, that is 1 by 16, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 5. Do it by yourself. Let us study about decimals. A rectangle with 10 equal parts is given, in which one part is colored. Express this in the form of decimals. You see here, a rectangle is given and it is divided into 10 equal parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In which one part is colored or shaded here. You have to express this in decimals. How to do it? First, you must write this in the form of fractions. So, in the form of fractions, how to write this? First, you have to write how many parts are there. How many equal parts are there? There are 10 equal parts in which one part is shaded. That means you can write it as one part is shaded out of 10 equal parts. So, the fraction will be 1 by 10. It is 1 by 10. We read it as 1 by 10. Now, how to write this in the form of decimals? See here, children. How many zeros are there in the unit place? 1. Then, in tens place, there is a number. So, here there is 1, 0. So, you can write it as in the form of decimals. You can write this as 0.1. We read this as 0.1. Okay, we read this as 0.1. Now, I will shade one more here. I will shade one more. So, what is the fraction? What is the fraction? Now, I have shaded 2 equal parts out of 10. So, what is the fraction? Fraction will be out of 10, 2 are shaded. So, it will be 2 by 10. Right. Now, how to write this in the form of decimals? There is 1 0 here and here there is 2. So, in the form of decimal, I can write it as 0.2. and I read this as 0.2. Okay, now let us consider one more. I will shade one more part here. Now you tell me, in fractions I can write it as 3/10, right? Out of 10 equal parts, 3 are shaded. And in decimal, I can write it as 0.3. I read this as 0.3. Is it clear to you all? See the circle here. It is divided into how many equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 equal parts here. In 10 equal parts, I am going to shade one of the part. So how to write this in the form of fractions? Out of 10, 1 is shaded. I can write it as 1 by 10, right? 1 by 10. How to write in the form of decimal? 0.1, 0.1, right? Now if I will shade 4 parts, okay? 1 is already shaded, I will shade 4 parts. Now tell me how to write in the form of fractions. 4 by 10 is also equal to, how to write in the fractions? I mean in the decimals, 0.4. We read this as 0.4, right? 0.4. To express a number in decimal, whole part must be divided into 10 equal parts, okay? Remember this, to express a number in decimal, the whole part should be divided into 10 equal parts. Here you see here, this is the decimal, right? 0.4 is the decimal. We call this point as decimal point. We call this point as decimal point. Okay? Decimal point. And the numbers towards this side are integers and this side are decimals. Now, 1 by 10, how you are writing in decimals? You are writing it as 0.1, isn't it? Because there is 1 0, you are writing 0.1. Suppose if I consider 1 by 100, how will you write in the form of decimals? First write this 0, put the decimal point, then there will be one more 0, right? Then here there is 1, so you write it as 0.1. So we read this as 0.01. Here point is nothing but the decimal point. We call it as a decimal point. Suppose if there is 1 by 1000, how will you write 0 point? This 0 is done. How many zeros extra here? 2 more. 0, 0, 1. So it is 0.001. Some fractions are given. You have to write their decimal form here. Okay. So you see here, 1 is the numerator, 10 is the denominator. So decimal form will be 0.1. See the next one. 2 by 10. 2 is the numerator, 10 is the denominator. Decimal form will be 0.2. This is the third one. 1 by 100. 1 is the numerator, 100 is the denominator. So it will be 0.01. Now, 2 by 100 will be 0.02. 3 by 100. So it will be 0.03. Now let us move on to the exercise. Exercise 9.3. Read the next decimals given below and write them in words. How will you write this? 0.0.2. Right? This one 0.5, 0.7, 0.21. So don't read it as 0.21. Always remember, after the decimal point, you have to read the numbers individually. This is not 21. You are reading it as, I'll write here 0.21. Suppose this is number, this number, you see here 0.02. See here, if you read it as 0.15, it is wrong. It is 0.15. It is 0.15. Write the decimals given below. 0.3, you can write it is easily 0.3. 0.6, done. 0.7, 0.4, 0.05, so 0.05. Write the next fractions in decimals. So you have to write this in decimals. So this one, it will be 0.1. Here 0.2. Do this one, I'll do the fifth one. So 2 by 100, it will be 0.02. Remaining solve by yourself.